there, Professor Kilcannon. My name is Shantalina Espinoza, and I did my research and report on health sciences. That's the major that I am in currently. I did make a PowerPoint, although with my camera quality, it doesn't show through, so I will just send it to you either way, so you do see that I did do it. Starting here, I researched basically five different career paths that you could do based on my major, and I found some of like the top ones that typically people know that I've actually been looking into as well. So like an anesthesiologist, their average salary is going to be $210,000 roughly. Their estimated growth rate right now is positive 22%, and it does require a postdoctoral training. Basically, what an anesthesiologist does is that they administer the anesthesia or the sedation during medical procedures. Although they don't just give the patient the medicine, they do monitor them before, after, and during the procedure, so they can counteract any adverse side effects. They record the type and the amount of anesthesia that they give each patient throughout the procedure, and they examine the patient. They obtain like medical history, and they do like diagnostic tests to determine risk basically during the procedure. They decide when the patient basically is recovered enough to head home, because as you've heard, I'm sure, they have a lot of risk after. Many people wake up with dizziness and vomiting, so they are the ones that actually clear the patient to be sent home. They also do perform little like side things such as like laboratory tests, they do x-rays, stuff like that. I also did look up dentist. Dentists make an average of $158,000 a year. Their estimated growth rate right now is a positive 15%, so it is good. And they do require a doctoral degree, which is pretty obvious. Basically, what they do is they administer anesthetics to limit the amount of pain. So if you're getting like a tooth pulled, they do like the little small anesthesias. They examine the teeth, your mouth, your gums, any issues relating towards dental or your mouth structure, they do. They perform x-rays, they use dental instruments and other different kinds of equipment. They evaluate dental health, diagnose diseases or any like abnormalities, and they plan like an appropriate treatment to help and solve that. They diagnose different diseases, injuries, malformations, so on and so forth. And basically they perform any oral or periodontal surgery on the jaw or the mouth. They also do have a business side. So they manage the business, they employ, and they supervise their staff, as well as handle paperwork and insurance claims. I also did choose to look at nurse practitioners, which is another field I was looking into. Their average is roughly around $67,000 to $70,000 a year. Their estimated growth right now is a positive 22%. And they do require only a master's degree, which kind of took me by surprise. I thought you needed more. I'm not sure why. But basically, they're just under a doctor. They prescribe medication dosage routes and frequencies based on the patient's characteristics of age and gender. They order and they perform and interpret the results of tests, such as like complete blood counts or like electrocardiograms, stuff like that they can look at. They also do diagnose and treat different health problems, such as like high blood pressure, like diabetes. They also do maintain complete detailed records of patients' health cares and like plans and prognosis. So they don't only do all medical, there is a business side to each of these. They also do perform routes or annual physical like examinations for like kids in like high school and stuff like that. They can do your physicals, or if you are just an adult and you needed a physical. Basically, they can also refer you. So if you're needed more medical attention, if you were to need more medical attention, they can refer you to a specialist that they know of offhand, and you can be sent to them like from the nurse practitioner. Basically, I chose also to do dental laboratory technicians, which is, their average salary is going to be $37,000 to $40,000 a year. Their estimated growth rate now is a little lower. It's only positive 14%, but you only need a high school diploma or GED, which astounded me. Basically, what this person does is they read prescriptions or examine models or impressions to help determine or design dental products to be constructed, so like moldings and crowns. They fabricate and alter or repair dental devices such as like dentures, bridges, inlays, appliances for basically like straightening your teeth. They remove excess metal or porcelain and polish surfaces of prosthetics or frameworks using polishing machines. They also do build or shape wax teeth using small hand instruments and information from observations or dentist specifications, which is pretty cool. I found that like crazy. I was like, what? The last one I decided to look at was clinical nurse specialist. They average around $67,000 to $70,000 a year. Their estimated growth right now is a positive 22%, and they require a master's degree. Basically, what they do is they observe, interview, and assess patients, to identify care needs. They monitor or evaluate medical conditions of patients in like collaborations with other healthcare professions, so they get feedback from other people that they've gone to. Basically, they plan, evaluate, and they treat based on like interviewing the patients. And then they maintain like departmental policies, procedures and objectives such as like infection control standards and stuff like that. They prepare reports to document patients' cares, activities, stuff like that, and they write nursing orders. So what I did is I found a major employer in my field, and I chose to do Shands Hospital because I live in Gainesville. They have a couple of different morals or beliefs, I like to call it. They have their vision, which is to create an unstoppable momentum toward the goal of improving individual and community health through discovery, clinical, and translational science and technology, exceptional education, and high-quality health care. So to break that down into smaller words, they harness the power of together. That's like their slogan. They value the focus on education and research. Since they are involved with the University of Florida, they work together to help to make things better, basically, to advance in technology and healthcare. So they also do hospitality within the business. So they don't only like to have they like to work together as colleagues and have support and treat each other with respect, because that's the baseline of the hospital. If they didn't have great teamwork, then they wouldn't have a smooth running hospital like they do. Then I went ahead and I chose a current issue, which I found and it's called Nurses Urge to More Vocal. Basically, what this was talking about was in the United Kingdom's leading nursing organization, the Royal College of Nursing, Peter Carter, who is the head of it, he's calling on nurses to basically vocalize and speak up about how much they're getting paid and their minimum wages. Because last year, only 16% spoke up during the colleagues' consultation on the pay dispute. He stated that after 8 years of work as chief executive and general secretary of the RCN, getting the mass of the members involved has been a huge challenge. Basically, I went ahead and I believed that this showed importance because nurses are basically the core of the hospital other than the doctor. They play a vital role in the treatment and care of the patients. So they're who you see typically more often if you are admitted in the hospital. You see the doctor like once every like 10 hours. So the nurses really do play a role in keeping up with the patients and monitoring them and relaying back information to the doctor if anything is going wrong. So without them, the hospitals wouldn't run as efficient as they do. The fact that only 16% were voicing their opinions on pay is devastating to me because they are just as important and should want to fight for a beneficial pay because they do a lot within the hospital. Hopefully, for the future, I hope that Mr. Carter can bring the issue up to the Council of 500 congressmen and some changes can be seen within the importance of this problem where no one wants to speak out and about because they don't believe that they're worth it. So that is my overall research. I will send you everything else that I did in detail. But thank you for listening. It was my pleasure.